There was a time during the 60th birthday when Swami came and told the students, you put up a program for my 60th birthday. That was a big responsibility, and of course it's exciting, but it also becomes a trouble because every day Swami will come and tell, so what is the new song? New song what, Swami? Every day Swami would want a new song. So Sonam Gyamso, one of the senior students who was a composer and a lead bhajan singer, he was under tremendous pressure. So he went and confided to Ratanlal aunty and said, aunty, I don't know what, Swami is every day asking me for new songs. Where do I get new songs from? She said, beta, I have got one old book with me. Very nice poems are there. It's wonderful poetry. You take that maybe and you will get some ideas. He said, yes. He went and he got that old book. It was torn, but the content inside was brilliant. Beautiful poetry. And he liked one poem in particular. He took that poem and composed two lines in the beginning.
नाम की ज्योत जलाई मन में जीवन सफल बनाया विषयों में जिनका मन भाया वृथा जन्म गवाया भजुरे परम नाम श्री साई
So he went into the interview room and with great joy with the harmonium he sang the whole song. And Swami looked at him and said, hey, attach two lines in the beginning and make it new song, is it? And then see the amazing thing, Swami said, I gave this song to Om Sharan. Brother Sonam confides that when he went through the book in one corner, one place, because one side will be the name of the book, other side will be the author's name. One page it had not got torn and there it was written Brahmachari Om Sharan, who later became Hari Om Sharan, who was known as the Bhajan Samrat of India. I don't know whether Hari Om Sharan knew about Swami or not, but that is the thing. The Lord knows. When you have love for the Lord, doesn't matter which form you worship. Whichever form you worship, it reaches the same Lord. Whether Swami was in Hari Om Sharan's list of gods, Hari Om Sharan was definitely in Swami's list of devotees.